According to sources from the White House who spoke to CNN late last week, both Ivanka Trump and Jared Kushner are panicking over their own futures. And no, by the way, it's not because of that report that came out showing they made the Secret Service pay $3,000 to rent basically a toilet because they didn't want to share a bathroom with them. No, no, no. They're panicking right now because they're concerned that Donald Trump, Ivanka's daddy, has ruined their careers, has destroyed their futures. You know, whether Ivanka wants to just continue on with her brand, if that's even still a thing, or if she wants to move into politics, she is panicking because she believes that daddy has now ruined that for her. As for Jared, I don't know why he's panicking, right? I mean, his dad actually had to get a presidential pardon from Ivanka's dad. Like, we know he's got a really shady, horrible history, and apparently that didn't bother anyone, and he was still able to go on and find a lot of new wealth, to put it as nicely as possible. So I'm not understanding why Kushner is panicking, and to be honest, I'm not exactly sure why Ivanka's panicking. Daddy didn't do anything that you weren't right there by his side to condone. Like, all the horrible things that happened from Trump, you were there. You were a part of it. Ivanka, you stood by his side. Not to mention the fact, if we're to believe reports that you may want to move down to Florida and run for office, let's not forget that you have the charisma of a box turtle. Now, that's not meant to be offensive to box turtles. I love turtles. But Ivanka has no personality. She has no real belief. Not really easy to get a gauge on what the hell she even believes as a person, where she stands, what she would do. Nevertheless, as I've repeatedly said, I do think if she came down here and ran against Marco Rubio, she'd destroy him. He is absolutely pathetically weak and not very smart. So yes, he's easy to beat in a primary, but he's going to be replaced, if it's with Ivanka, by somebody who's only marginally, more charismatic and intelligent. And again, that's not because she just went along with everything daddy did. It's because of who she is as a person. Now, she inherited a lot of things from her father, mostly money, his charisma, his ability to manipulate people. She didn't get that. Don Jr. didn't really get it either, but out of all the kids, he has the most of it. Eric didn't get any of it. Eric is at the shallow end of the gene pool. He's basically in the kiddie pool of the gene pool at this point. So yeah, they don't have what he had to go out there and be able to find the success in the way that he had. But she's going to sit there and she's going to blame him forever. And I just don't think that's fair. Certain aspects of it, sure, Trump is responsible for it. But she was by his side every step of the way. She cannot separate herself from the things her father did. She cannot separate herself from the things her father said, and she can't separate herself from the events of January 6th. She was there with him every step of the way. So to blame him for destroying her potential career after leaving the White House? Nah, that's cheap. That's taking the easy out. That's her not having to accept blame for what she's done. And hey, I guess in that regard, there's something she did get from daddy. The inability to accept blame for her own actions. One of today's video sponsors is Privacy. And right now, they have a wonderful offer for all of our Ring of Fire viewers. Go to privacy.com/ROF. Sign up for your Privacy account and you will receive $5. Privacy.com, their service is absolutely one of the most vital in an online world today, especially during the pandemic. Everyone is encouraged to stay home, so we're ordering more things online. And so your bank account information is more vulnerable than ever. Privacy gives you security. This is a product that I use all of the time. And here's why. If you have ever had your bank account information stolen, if it's been part of a data leak, that is a massive headache trying to get your money back, trying to repair your credit. Privacy helps take away some of that concern. What privacy does is it provides a browser extension, or you can go right into the website or into the app, and it can create a virtual bank account or credit card number. It could be a temporary number that only is used one time, or it can be merchant specific, meaning you can create a bank account card that only works for one particular website. So if that account happens to get hacked or has a massive data breach, that card number no longer works with any other website. That is how privacy helps protect your bank account information in an increasingly insecure online world. So again, go to privacy.com/ROF. You get $5 free just for signing up. Or if you don't want to type it in, just click the link at the top of the video description below.